hook, that's at the shoulder, just repeat it on to the other side, and then it's ready to be redesigned. Hello fashion sewers, I hope you are well. If you're new to my channel, I'm Colleen G. Lee. Let's get into the video. So this is the jacket that I will be refashioning, and I'm going to be turning it into a waistcoat. What drew me to this jacket was this simple belt. I don't think it's leather, is it? No, it's not leather. And the fact that it fits me well. And there is an issue with the shoulder, and I probably think that's the reason why it's gone into a charity shop and it still had the swing ticket on it, because there seems to be too much fullness on the shoulder, which can be remedied, which I'll obviously do that when I actually cut this into a waistcoat. So I'm going to keep most of the body of the jacket, but I'm going to be removing the sleeves, and I'm going to try and put the sleeves back into the jacket, which will then become a waistcoat. And then I'll probably have a bit of left over from cutting away of the, I'm going to keep the collar and the lapel, that I'll definitely keep. And then I probably just need to rethink how I'm going to keep most of the fabric onto this, because waistcoats, generally speaking, I've got like a satin back and the fabric is at the front. It depends, that's what men's waistcoats are like really, but it will have an inspiration of a waistcoat to this. So I think the first thing I need to do is just remove the sleeves and try it on. This is the issue. Yeah, it's sometimes a little bit on that side, but it's mainly on this side. Yeah. Okay. Right. So as you can see, I've removed the sleeves, and it's about me cutting it at this angle, I think. So let's see. If I cut, ooh, that's looking nice, complete there without me having to cut, that would be really, hey, that might solve the problem with this side. Yes, that looks nice. Oh, let me put some pins in. Put some pins in before I lose the effect. I'm just going to step back and look into a mirror up there. Oh, that's nice. I like that actually. So it may mean I just sew the shoulder seam and that should stay in place. Me having to sew it down. Liking that, but I think I'm gonna have to sort out this. I'm gonna have to take this in a little bit. That seems to be creating, can you see how higher it is to that side? So I'm going to have to make that seam a bit bigger in order to get that to lie flat. But that looks nice. And then what I could do then is cut, I'll make a bigger seam. The armhole, maybe not. Oh, I think I may resolve this without too much waste to the front, at least anyway. That is nice. I like that. And then I'll solve that first before I. It's nice. Okay. Liking that. Yeah, that's nice. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll sew along the shoulder seam to secure this pleats in place. I'll make the shoulder seam larger on that side and do exactly the same that I'm doing here, and then the armhole, I'll turn it in on itself. And yes, you've guessed, I'm going to hand sew that into position. So this lovely curve will stay, and this pleating on top is nice because that feels comfortable. Let me just button that. Yeah, that looks gorgeous. So what I'm going to do with the back though, that's the problem, isn't it? Let me show you the back. Okay. I do like that effect on the back. I'm assuming that will stay in place if I just sew it down on the seam. There isn't much waste then. Right. Yeah, I do like that. Right, so the belt. Nice. Okay, I want to include the belt somehow. Taking the belt loops. I want the belt to be part of part of the design, redesign of this jacket. So we've got some loops here. Yeah, I can attach it there, and they also have this as well, which is binding that was on this top that I've taken off. I feel as though that needs to be part of it as well. Need to figure that out. Maybe towards the back detailing, or this goes towards the back. But this, I definitely want this to be part of it, and this as well. That's nice. Okay, so I need to play around with this because I think I want this to come to some of this binding to come to the back. I'm not sure whether it's going to be this, the belt, the original belt that came with the jacket. It's going to be this. We shall see. Hello, fashion sewers. As you know, I'm Colleen G. Lee. I'm here to inspire, motivate, and share ideas for refashioning clothing. If you are into that sort of thing, consider subscribing. Not only that, you can join my CGL membership, which is part of this channel. So please do click the subscribe button, then click the join button in order to get extra perks from me on my channel. Let's get back to the video. So sort this shoulder out first, which just means I need to make this shoulder seam slightly bigger. I need to get my seam ripper and just tape, unstitch that, and then just do a straight line of sewing just there. And that hopefully will resolve the issue. Okay, that's done. I've sewn the shoulder. Now, this is going to be the tricky part, which is to making sure. So this is the sleeve lining. This is the armhole of the lining as well. And as you can see, it does look as though it needs pressing. I wouldn't do that. I wouldn't press it unless it's really bad, because you may just lose the print or the indentation of the stitching. I mean, you can always try, but it will be easier to do so. but I'm just going to follow the original seam line in the lining and then place some pins in position to hold it in place. Just keep going round like so. And then once I have done that, I will baste. See, following the stitch line in the lining and placing it in position like so. And pin. When you come to the top of the sleeve, the shoulder area, you're going to find there's going to be a little bit of fullness at the top. Let me just go around this way so I can show you. You just need to put a little bit of a pleat. It's best that it's at the top because of the curve of the shoulder. See, there's a bit of fullness there. So all you need to do then is just create a little bit of a tuck like so. So you've got a little bit of a pleat that's happening there. And that's at the shoulder seam. And then just do it like that in place. So that's done. Let me show you the other one. So that is what you're looking to achieve. So it's base, and all I need to do is slip stitch, and there's that little tuck that's at the shoulder. Just repeat it on to the other side, and then it's ready to be redesigned. I based both armholes, and now I'm ready for the permanent hand sewing, which is the slip stitch. Finished my hand sewing. There we go. How gorgeous is that? So the next thing is to put the pleat at the top, the shoulder area. So it will just be a case of folding one on top of the other, like so, and then putting a couple of pins in. Now you see that's quite thick. It's not impossible, depending on the type of sewing machine that you have, to actually stitch this into position. Let me just show you the wrong side. That's all nice and neat. So you could actually, on your sewing machine, just sew along the seam of the shoulder there, which will flatten it and maybe depends on the actual fabric of your jacket as well. But I'm just going to hand sew mine, so I'm going to hand sew it along here. Just small, tiny slip stitching, just to keep that in place, because I want the volume to be there. I don't want it to be flattened. And yeah, and then the next thing after that will be to work out an idea with these, how I'm going to put these little strands, these strips of belts. I definitely want that to be part of the jacket, because I think it will just help with the aesthetic to this waistcoat. But that's the next step that I need to do. So now I'm ready to hand sew this pleat into position, and it's just a case, because there isn't that much to actually sew. Just take your time and just do very tiny slip stitches. Okay, you want to make sure that it stays in place. There we have it. Yes. It's gorgeous. Yeah. So there's been no waste, which is a thumbs up, that's great. The sleeves will definitely get used in another project. But no, I'm happy with the result. I'm glad there's been no waste. But I still think it's a little bit bland though. Excuse me, I'm just looking in the mirror here. I do think that I need to think about how I'm gonna use the belt. There isn't that much of it. What I don't want to, I want to utilize the loops, thread loops. So if your jacket doesn't have any thread loops, I do have a video tutorial on how to create your own, so I'll link that in the description below. But yeah, so how am I going to be using that? See, even though it's so thin, it's so effective, that black. No, I can't use it that way because I won't be able to get into the jacket, will I? It's a case of kind of using it like this, how I did it before, I think. Maybe put here, see, I like that effect. So let's go back to how I did it earlier on. Just bring me down a little bit so that you can see. Oh, by the way, I'm definitely keeping this collar up and that one down. That's just my thing. My thing, so it's not something that you need to do. It's just that when I was trying it on, it's like, and that's flipped up. It's like, ooh, I'm liking that. And you know, I'm an asymmetrical girl. So yeah. So let's bring this down just a bit. Separate through the other loop. I'm going to use every bit of it. See, like that. So it may mean I have to tack it into place. See, that's nice. Shallow pockets. And then maybe this bit will go towards the back, so you know, to create a harness kind of effect. So I mean, it's not going to be possible for me to do this while I've got it on, but something like that, maybe just tack it there in position and then bring these around to the front, maybe tie. But I definitely want it to be in there because it is very effective. Yeah, the tie towards the front. So let's give that a go. So I'm going to have to take the jacket off in order to see if it works. But that's okay, I like that. Okay. So I'm going to work on the back first. I'm going to get this one and place it in position, and I've got a centre back seam here that I can just about see, which is here, but you can just fold your jacket in half and find the centre back. So I'm going to pin that into position like this. Okay, and then still following with the centre back seam here, I'm going to place this here, so it's quite loose. I'm going to pin that into position, creating like a V effect. I'm not going to apologize for more hand sewing, but I think there's going to be some more hand sewing. Yeah, that looks gorgeous actually. That is so gorgeous. Just turn that pin like that, twisted. It's going to be slightly twisted, but it's only slight, so that isn't a big major issue. It's just that when it was on another garment, it overlapped. But this is the beauty of the future of clothing. There'll just be some strategic, I hope I said that right, placing of hand stitching to keep these in place. So I'll hand stitch there, along here, and along there. I wouldn't bother with that. I want that to be loose. But that looks amazing already. And then I'll bring these through the loop that is already here, fighting for position with the original belt, and do the same on the other side. Now the original belt is allowing it to be placed inside, it's not causing any issues. That looks amazing, doesn't it? Okay, let's see what it looks like at the front. Right. We just release that pin there, just interfering with the inside a little bit. There we go. And that one there. Which one is that one? That one. Yeah, just releasing it just a bit. Yeah, that's fine. Okay. A lot better. So let's bring, so it means I should be able to tie this at the front just about. Yes, that's fine. Yep, need to tie that at the front. Hopefully I will be able to. I won't know that until I actually try it on. So let's see what we can do with the original belt. Oh, I might be able to get the original belt into the pocket. Maybe. And then maybe I want this to be loose as well and tack it in position here or create little loops here. So let's pin that into each pocket. and then try it on and see what happens. Ooh, I'm quite excited about this actually. Okay. Yes, let's open this up and let's try it on.
I can feel it tugging on my pockets a little bit. It's not bad. I like this as well, yeah. On my natural waistline. Nice. We turn round so that you can see. Does it look okay? I like it. Nice, but I do feel it tugging on the pockets. Let me see. Let me just take the pin out. Maybe I won't have this in the actual loop. I think I'll put it further in this area here of the pocket, at the start of the pocket. So I'm going to take it out of the loop. Okay, it's out of the loop. So that looks nice in the loop. Yeah, that feels comfortable now that I'm positioning it here. I won't put it inside of the pocket. You can do. If it feels uncomfortable, it feels absolutely bad, but I like the knot. So I'm going to put it alongside, like so. And do the same on the other side. I like it. I like it. I do. Show you the back again. I do like it. I'm playing around with it. Yeah, maybe I like it more. But my objective is to use as much as possible everything that I'm refashioning, and it still looks aesthetically pleasing, and that still does, and I like it. Yeah. One with a black polo knit would be gorgeous. Just need to steam that a bit more so it stays in place. I think this is excellent. Let me just play around with this a bit more. Or maybe I'll put it halfway. Let's have a look. Just tie this on the in, not in a bow. I just do it as a tie. Yes. Yeah. Got it. Yeah. Yes. That's gonna look amazing, especially if I wore it with a black polo knit, but that is Yeah, I've got it. Yes. And I think because these look like buttons, because it's actually, there's knots on the end of this, it coincides with that. You can see the back better than I can, but I have done the double mirror thing. And yeah, I like it. That looks good. Right, so. It's getting late now, and I just have a little bit of hand sewing to do in certain areas. Not a lot, but I'm going to do that. I'm going to relax and then do the hand sewing, and then you will see this when it's finished.
So let me just show you the hand sewing that I've been doing. So I've hand sewn that into position, that into position, and that in position. So three tack, it's just a tack over and over and again, about six times actually, to keep them in place. And I also tacked in position along the back of the collar. So that is the back. And I also did the same with the original belt. So it's just a case of going over and over again. It can move, so yeah. Yeah, it's very effective. So the front, I put the belt around the collar. As you know, I've got one collar that will be standing. It's just free flowing, if you like. And I have just tacked it into position just below the pocket there on both. And this was part of the back, and it just, you can have it straight down. Where am I? And yeah, I might change the buttons out, you know. The buttons are nice, they are pretty, but I think I just want dense black buttons. I think I actually do prefer to have a shank button, so whenever I've got time or if I've got any black shank buttons this size, then I would definitely put shank buttons on there. These are flat ones. So yeah, the project is now complete.
So here we have it. So gorgeous. Oh, it's gorgeous, it really is. I just love what's happening with the belt now that it's gone around my neck, the collar I should say, and down the sides, and you've got this space happening here. Absolutely gorgeous. And yes, I will be, I need to steam it a little bit more. I just want to get this video out of the way and uploaded. So this will be staying, one half of the collar and lapel will be in this position. So I've steamed it a little bit, but it does need a bit more steaming. If it doesn't stay, then I'll put a press stud there, because that's the look I love, and that's what I'll go for. But the tucks have really formed pretty well, and I seem to resolve the issue with that one. Yeah, because that was the one that was a little bit, had too much fullness in the shoulder. So yeah, so let me just slowly turn you around. You can see the armhole, and then you've got this tuck that's happening at the back shoulders, but that's fine. And then you've got this detail at the back. It's just, yeah, this is the reason why we have to refashion compared to what it looked like before, what it looks like now. So I've got the option to tie it in place. I wish. But yeah, it's gorgeous, that's all I can say. But I'm more than likely will wear it like that, because I like that kind of continuation going all the way past the hemline. Yeah. But it's nice to have another option, isn't it? side view. Okay.
Lost for words. Yes again, I think. I'm just so happy with the results. It really is. I just hope that I am motivating you and inspiring you to do a similar project and showing you how easy it is, hopefully. I'm showing you how easy it is to actually transform a garment into something else and it becomes completely wearable. There may be little bits of aesthetics to it that you may be thinking, oh, it's not lying the way I want it to lie. Do not worry about that. That's the new way garments are going to look like in the future. If we are going to refashion garments, then we have to understand that these little things we don't need to worry about. As long as the garment feels comfortable, yes it does, it looks aesthetically pleasing for future mindsets, then you've done the job. So yes, and so I'm happy with all the projects that I've done on my channel so far. I'm gonna keep on doing this as long as you want it. So if you enjoyed this video, please think about subscribing. So if you're new to my channel, then definitely subscribe because there's lots more interesting and more in-depth projects to come. If you haven't, what are you waiting for? So give it a thumbs up, please do comment, share, save this project and any other project for you to do in the future. And yeah, I am loving what I am wearing. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next time.